السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. أما بعد, today's session we have a few questions, and the questioner's initials are KR. First question says, I am at a new school and have 3 minutes between periods to pray dhuhr. Is it permissible to pray 2 rak'ah qasr salah, or should I pray the regular 4 rak'ah? Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. First and foremost, we say that the prayer is from the most important things that a Muslim must do in his daily life, rather in his entire life. The prayer is the second pillar of al-Islam. It is something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made obligatory upon all of his slaves, those who are learned and those who aren't learned, those who are wealthy and those who are not wealthy, men and women, black and white, red and yellow, those who are traveling, those who are residents, those who have good physical health, and those who suffer from poor physical health. No matter what the case is, if you have your sense of awareness, your mental faculty, if you're in a sane state, then you must offer the prayer. There are so many different verses in the Quran al-Kareem and in the authentic hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that show us the importance of the prayer, its virtue, the severe sin and crime of those who do not perform it, or those who waste it, the dispraise of those who stand lazily therein, and the list goes on. The Messenger of Allah has told us that the thing between us and them, the non-Muslims, the rejectors of faith, is the prayer, waliyadu billah. So therefore, Allah Azza wa Jalla, He tells us in Surah An-Nisa, speaking about the verse of that which the ulama of Islam call Ayatul Khawf, or Salatul Khawf, the prayer of fear. In other words, when the Muslims have met their enemies, they are not exempt from offering the prayer. Allah Azza wa Jal tells them what to do, and He instructs them. One group of Muslims should stand in the front, while another group of Muslims offers the prayer in the back. One group of Muslims the Imam is to stay with, and another group of Muslims the Imam, so on and so forth, etc. The topic of our discussion here is not the rulings of the prayer of fear, but I'm trying to get to a point, and that is, after Allah Azza wa Jalla instructed the believers, instructed the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam with regards to the prayer in this time of fear, He says, establish the prayer. When you feel safe, when you're at ease, when you have the ability, establish the prayer. إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ كَانَتْ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ كِتَابًا مُنْقُوتًا. Because the prayer is obligatory upon the believers in a prescribed time. In other words, the believers, when they're doing such a serious act as fighting in Allah's cause, they are not exempt from offering the prayer in the proper manner, in the proper time. So therefore, if that's the case with regards to that verse, then what about when you're home, when you're not fighting in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's cause, the prayer is even more serious. Okay, so therefore, under any circumstance, is a believer allowed to shorten his prayers, and he's not a traveler? The only time in which you're allowed to shorten your prayers is when you are traveling. As for combining the prayers when you're not traveling, that's a different issue. Okay, that's a definition that we're not getting into right now. But shortening them is from the specifics of the traveler. When the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam offered the prayer in the authentic hadith, okay, in Bukhari Muslim, and he salamed out after he made 2 rak'ah. He made rak'atain, 2 units of the prayer. That man, Dhul Gadain, he said, was the prayer shortened, or did you forget, O Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? The Messenger alayhi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, I didn't forget, nor was the prayer shortened. He says, rather you have, O Messenger of Allah. The point that we're trying to get to, as hadith clearly proves, that if a man only makes 2 rak'ah, his prayer is incomplete, and it is not considered to have been fulfilled. So therefore, you are not allowed to shorten your prayers unless you are a traveler. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala surely knows best.